Defense. We played defense. We got stops. We got out in transition. We made shots.
You guys are on the road again after this. 13-1 at home. Franchise best record, but again, this struggles on the road so far. How do you guys just carry that success on the road? I mean, it's 6 games in 9 nights for you guys?
One game at a time. Build off good habits, learn from the bad, and just take it one game at a time.
Paul, Melo spoke very glowingly about you and Kawhi's support that you guys showed the other day when you were talking about him. Can you just speak about what it was like to actually see him on the floor tonight, be able to play against them, and kind of how it feels for you guys to all have like that level of camaraderie together as players?
Yeah, it's great. It's great. I think, you know, it just shows the level of respect we have for Melo, and, you know, what he's done for this league, who he's been to us in this league. But it was great to share the court with him again. We were out there, we had laughs. We competed, we battled. It felt like old times of having him on the court. But it's great. I think it's great for the league. And, I'm going to always have his support and be happy for him.
Speaking about Melo, obviously you guys shared a relationship. What were some of the things that you guys were able to take away from each other and learn from each other to make you guys better basketball players?
I think my time with Melo was, you know, he was the enforcer, really. I mean, you know, my time with him in Oklahoma, the times with Rocky, you know, he was the one that kind of leveled us and, you know, kept everything positive, smooth sailing. I thought him and Russ did an unbelievable job of that. But he was the big brother. He was the mentor. He was the, you know, he's the one that got me this chain. The list goes on with Melo did for me there. But I think the biggest thing to take away was just his big brother. It was, you know, bad nights, the arm around the shoulder. Good nights, the encouragement. I mean, he was just a positive influence.
There's a ton of NBA players who have never played with Melo that still seem to be really fond of him. He seems important to the NBA culture. What is it? Is it just his style of play? Is it, what is it about him that kind of sets him apart from other?
I think his approach, you know, his approach. I grew up, you know, with the Lakers playing Denver Nuggets in that era, and Kobe being my favorite player, and Melo giving it everything, giving Kobe everything he had. You know, that matchup, you know, really what made me the biggest fan of Melo. And then having the first opportunities to play against him, I understood why he's so hard to guard. It's just his relentlessness, how hard he plays, it was never a night off going against Melo. You were sore, you were bruised, you were hurting after playing against Melo. So I think that's what everybody kind of remembers, the vintage Denver and then the New York Knicks, Melo. That's what everybody remembers, and I think that's where everybody has a heart for when you think of Melo.
Doc has mentioned that Landry might return on this 6-game trip. How do you envision him fitting in offensively with you guys, especially with his shooting and spacing?
Yeah, not missing a beat. Another guy that spaces the floor, another guy that plays defense. It's a weapon on both ends. That's what we're adding back into our group.
You and Kawhi have both mentioned that you're not a fan of all the narratives surrounding Melo. Do you feel like he's finally getting the credit he deserves, especially after receiving Player of the Week?
Yeah. It's still, I'm not going to be happy with it because of how they tried to, you know, shoot him down when he first started. I'm not going to be happy now that he's playing well and, you know, they want to be on his side. Like, you know, he's going to have a long season. Let him play. Let him hoop. Say what you want when he's finished, but let him hoop. It's great that he's getting that recognition now when it's all said and done, but I think people just let him play, let him hoop. It's tough regardless when he came back. He's been out over a year. So it's going to be some ups and downs, but and just let Melo hoop.
Paul, you know very well what CJ and Dame can do together in that court. Considering this defense is still learning as it goes right now with not much practice time, I think they missed two of their 15. I mean, they made only two of their 15 three-pointers tonight. What's that tell you about the capability of this defense, even as it's in short term still learning as it goes?
Yeah, we just have a lot of defenders. A lot of smart defenders. It's one thing to have guys that play defense, but it's another when you got guys that love to play defense and know how to play defense. You just got so many of them out there that, you know, there's an alertness, there's an awareness at all times. Who's the matchups? Who's the hot guys? Who do we want the ball out of? You know, what guys we want the ball out of their hands? We kind of all talk about that throughout the game on matchups and who gets what. So, again, it's just one thing to have, you know, a roster just full of guys that know how to play the defensive end.
All right, two more.
Paul, you mentioned that Carmelo gifted you with that chain. What is your relationship like with him off the court?
It's great. It's great. You know, and my relationship goes further than Oklahoma. I really got close with him when we were on the Olympic team. Being in Brazil for months, you know, that's where my relationship really got good. But he's, you know, it's great when he's going through his times now, sending a text here and there. Keep his head up, stay with it. You know, and then you know, we'll talk again, I'm sure, coming up. But it's a big brother, little brother relationship.
Paul, the other day you said that the office is still a work in progress because you guys came from different programs. Doc tonight said he felt like it's still a bit of like your turn, my turn, his turn. Do you feel that out on the court? Do you feel the adjustments being made on the court? And how do you, why is that? How do you get better at that?
I'm sorry, ask you again.
Well, you know, Doc said tonight he felt like it's still like your turn, my turn on offense. Mm-hmm. How do you make it more of a flow offense?
I think, again, just chemistry, learning chemistry. I think right now everybody is, you know, in a good way. Like, you know, hey, I just got a good look. I got me a shot. Like, hey, you know, you got a mismatch. You take him. It's been that kind of feel. I think once we get to a point where we're just playing, the ball moves around, the ball hops around. And we show that throughout a game. It's not that every possession you come down, it feels like, you know, someone's getting a shot or has the, you know, mindset of getting a shot that play. It's not necessarily that, but I think everyone's trying to be aggressive. And, you know, everybody's trying to find their game. They're trying to find their way into the system. So I think it's more so that. But once we continue to keep playing, we'll build that chemistry.
All right, thank you.